Yo, what's up guys? So today I'm going to be showing you how you can make your video edits look way better on Instagram. Alright, so just a quick thing before we get into this. This is going to be done in Premiere Pro. I know this can't be done in iMovie because it's very limited on how you can crop your video. I don't know that much about Final Cut Pro, but maybe you might be able to do this, so the steps might be similar, I'm not sure. Anyway, if you're using Premiere Pro and you want to do this, it's going to be super, super easy, and it's definitely going to up your game on Instagram. It'll take away the black bars, and it'll put your video in portrait mode, which is way more engaging on Instagram and way more likely to get more likes, views, whatever you're on Instagram for. So I'm not going to talk about this too much. Let's just jump right into Premiere Pro and get started. All right, so I got Premiere Pro already opened up, and right here I just have a project that I've been working on, a little demo video that I made while I was in New York, and I'm just going to set my in and out points to the places that I want to export it at. I'm going to come up here to File, and then click Export, and then hit Media, and it's going to just render out the spots that I clicked the in and out for. Then what you're going to want to do is make sure your format's in H.264. This is pretty much the most common codec that YouTube and Instagram and stuff uses. And then you're gonna come down to the bottom here. If you hit preset, and there's actually a preset for YouTube 1080, which is what I'm gonna select because there's a good chance I'm gonna try to upload this to YouTube as well. Then what you wanna do is click match source. And then if you come down to bitrate settings, you can do VBR one pass, or sometimes I do VBR two pass, which does two passes of all your video and gives a little bit more information to scenes that are closer up and need more information, and less information to wider scenes that don't need as much detail in all the small areas. And then last thing you want to do is hit render at maximum depth and use maximum render quality. And then all you gotta do is click export. I actually already have this exported, so what we're gonna do now is just close out of this project, come to your main menu, open up new project. I already have one set up for this anyway. It's called Insta, so I'm just gonna open that up, but you can open up a new project or whatever. Okay, so we're gonna do two things here. We're gonna import two files. The first file is gonna be the one you just exported, and the second one's gonna be another video file that I will leave the link in the description for. I actually got this file from Taylor Cut Films, and it's just basically a 2K video file that's set in a vertical crop, and that's how you're gonna set your sequence settings. It's way easier to do this just to drop it in. So just import those files. And then all you gotta do is drag the vertical Instagram file and drop it right in the timeline right there, and you'll see that it comes up. It says a Taylor Cut Film. So then all you're gonna wanna do after that is take your video file and drag it right in the timeline next to it. And right away you're gonna see that you have these huge black bars. What you're gonna wanna do here is just click on this file right here so it opens up your video effect controls. And then all you have to do is take the scale and just bring it all the way up until it fills the screen. You might think this is counterintuitive, but you'll see that you're actually not losing a lot of quality, and this is pretty much what Instagram does to your videos anyway if you just take a regular video and press that arrow to crop it. There's gonna be some things off-center in your video because you zoom in so much, so if you wanna fix that, you just gotta come scroll around until the first frame of that scene happens or you wanna change it. Keep going, and then you're gonna wanna find the very first frame of the next scene and just cut right there. The first frame of the scene you want and the first frame of the next scene that's starting is where you're gonna make your cuts. And then all you're gonna wanna do is just adjust your position until it matches, probably not vertical because it's already scaled up, but your position like this, and you can see you have plenty of room to work with here. So I'm gonna just move this so he's in the center of the frame and then play it, and then boom. It's way more appealing, and you can go through and do this to all the clips that you want to make sure they're centered. Alright, so once that's done, all you're going to have to do is come up and export this again. So you're just going to set your in and out points to the cut here. Just start it here at the end, and then all the way at the end here. Just set an out point right there. Alright, and then you're just going to want to come up to File, Export again, Media, and then we're going to also export this in H.264. The sequence settings of this project are exactly the way they're gonna wanna be kept, so you're gonna wanna make sure you hit match source in the preset, and also match source down the basic video settings. This is gonna keep your video at a 2K video file at 24 frames per second, which is cinematic, and then you just wanna do the same thing, render maximum depth, use maximum render quality. You can do two pass if you want, but the bit rate and everything like that's all set, and then all you gotta do is press export, and then again, I already have this exported, so I'm not gonna do that, but you can just come out of here and then close out Premiere Pro and you're all set. And then the final step after that is just sending it to your phone. If you have a YouTube, You should have a Google Drive account and you can log into that and just upload your video file that way. Or if you have an iPhone and you're using an Apple computer, you can turn on Bluetooth and then you can just come up to your Finder, go to AirDrop, make sure Bluetooth and Wi-Fi are on your phone, and you should be able to see your phone pops up here. Then just find the file that you want to send to your phone. I think it's this one for me, 1234. Drop it right here. The message will come up on your phone and all you have to do is hit accept. And then from there, you can just upload it to Instagram. And you don't have to, if your coloring and stuff's all there, you can just throw in your caption, don't need any filters and stuff like that, and then upload it. And it looks way better on Instagram than if you had just uploaded a widescreen video with those bars and everything. And the reason why it's exported at a 2K video file is because Instagram uses compression in their videos anyway. So if you try to scale it up like that in the crop for Instagram and sent it out as a 1080p file and then Instagram compressed it, it's just gonna look awful. Whereas if you do it this way and you export it to 2K, it's gonna compress it and you're gonna lose some quality obviously, but it's gonna look a lot better than if you just exported a 1080p. All right, so that's it for this tutorial, guys. I hope it helped you out. Hopefully you'll be able to start utilizing these tips and make your Instagram videos look way better. And if you want to see the edit that I was working on for this, just head over to my Instagram account, which is a.crossley with two Y's, and follow me on there and I'll follow you guys back so I can check out your work and see how your vertical edits came out. And then if you like this video, please make sure to leave it a like and then subscribe to this channel. I'm going to be trying to post tutorials every Tuesday now, and I might be doing like some cinematic vlog thing sort of on Thursday as a challenge for myself to keep making videos. But that's it for today, guys. Hopefully you guys found something useful out of this, and I try to keep it short, but give me your opinions, what you think I should work on my tutorials, what you think I should do in the next tutorial. And until next week, guys, see you then. Sorry about that.